You have entered the Plumbing Business Success Zone, teaching entrepreneurs the business of plumbing. This is Potty Talk Live, recorded live every week. Turn on notifications to never miss an episode. Now your host, Richard Behney, the Million Dollar Plumber.
Areas you got to be digging in with your plumbing business is hiring.
Yeah.
As you heard me say, and Ryan, you know, I'm all about always recruiting.
Mm-hmm. And so
as we're recruiting, okay, let me pick your brain here a little bit. I know you got all the answers, but keep it simple for me, man, okay? Mm-hmm. Or don't go too deep on
You're
me,
just
all
a
right?
Plumber, right?
All right, I'm just a plumber. I'm a master plumber.
That's true.
Which means I can multiply, not just add. Okay. All right. Okay. All right. What are applicants overall looking for? Plumber applicants. What do you say is like the main thing they're looking for when in a new plumbing business, a company that they're looking at?
I'm going to be honest with you. They're probably looking for something different. And that's probably, if you take one thing away, most business owners mess up because they focus on what are our competitors doing and they copy them. And when you do that, if there's a bad habit in the industry, you just sucked it up, right? And while you might think that means that you're keeping up, when you go to try and steal your competitors' talent away, like they want something different. That's where you start. Like, what do they want? They want something different. Maybe it's better training. Maybe it's a better mentor. I can tell you, I got an ad right here in front of me. Best example of where we go wrong. Down here in the benefits, it says 12 unpaid vacation days yearly and 12 unpaid sick days yearly. Mm-hmm. Those 12 numbers are really big. You get 24 days off. Holy crap, that's awesome. Unpaid. 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 Now, as entrepreneurs, we mess up because we're like, somebody comes to you and says, hey, I want paid time off. And you're like, hell yeah, me too. I never get paid time off. I'm working all the freaking time.
Right.
These guys are not entrepreneurs. They're your employees. You're an entrepreneur. You're the one that gets the surf boat.
Right.
They're the ones that signed up to not start their own business. And this perfect, I just floated up while I was in the green room, pulled up a job. I'm like, oh, you got to be kidding me. Mm. What? And their competitors are probably like, dude, we'll let you not come to work and not pay you for 14 days.
Right.
You know, they want to get paid not to work. That
right.
is how it works. If I'm sick, I still have to pay the power bill. And so if you look at what do right. they want, they want something different. And the easiest way to do that, go look at Indeed or Glassdoor and read the negative reviews about your competitors. Mm-hmm. It will tell you exactly what they want. Most likely, it's their training sucks. It was a giant mess. I didn't know what was expected. Mm-hmm. They didn't take care of me. Mm-hmm. And as entrepreneurs, we're like, we're not signing up to take care of you. Yeah, that's what we're signing up to do.
Right.
Unless you want to create entrepreneurs. If you treat your entrepreneurs, you're going to create entrepreneurs out of them.